Okay, Brad, we're live. Okay, welcome everybody to Wall Street Reporter's next Super Stock live stream for today, Friday, December 18th. We have back with us again Skylight Health, Brad Shekar, the CEO. Brad, welcome back.
Jack, I love to be back on the show. Happy to be here.
Brad, we're going to talk about the exciting new developments that are happening with the stock, right? Well, with the company. I'm talking. Look, what's happening with the business? I'm thinking of this of the stock. Let me put this up here. This is okay. Here we go. Skylight Health. We got SHG, SHGFF over the counter. Anybody that's new tuning in, our goal is to bring you stocks which we believe have that 10x to 100x upside potential. So these are companies going after multi-billion dollar massive market opportunities. They're at a key inflection point right now in their growth, where they're just about to take off, or they're taking off already, actually, is a better description. And there's multiple catalysts in place that can drive an increase in valuation, a massive increase in valuation, an increase in the business, and all those other good things. And of course, a lot of the companies that we've had on our live streams in the past year have done very well. Number of 10 baggers, 20 baggers, 5x, 10x, it's been all over the map. So we're going to find out today if Skylight is going to be, we're changing. We're going from 10 baggers to 100 baggers. Pratt, so you're going to have to, we're
Set
raising
the
that
bar high.
standard.
Do it. Set the bar high. Do it. Now do it.
We're raising
We're
our
on it. Set
standard.
the bar high.
Perfect. So Pratt, it's been a week since we last had you on, and you've had three major announcements. And I think the last one, I don't think the market really quite got it. I don't think they really understood, because the stock hasn't reacted to it, which is the discount drug card. And I want you to explain that. We'll cover, that. We'll talk about the TSX venture uplisting, the raise. You're doing a $12 million raise. How are you going to deploy that growth capital in 2021? So all that. But just for context, or again, for anybody new, just give us a snapshot of Skylight, the business model, the market you're going after, all that good stuff.
So we talk a lot about multi-billion dollar opportunities, right? And so we're still confident this is a multi-trillion dollar industry. And this is healthcare, US healthcare. It's a destination for most, and we are there, and we are starting to accelerate our growth in that space. We have an opportunity to create a strong business model on the back of what has been conventionally owned by large corporate health institutions. And we're going to disrupt this space. And we're going to consolidate and add significant organic growth. Our job in this space is at the first milestone, 1 million patients with unit economic value of $1,000 per patient through insurable services to create a billion-dollar revenue stream with strong 20% to 30% operating EBITDA margins. And that, I think, is not the end point. That is just the first milestone. And what we can achieve beyond that is just going to be continued by growing ourselves through consolidation and adding tremendous value as experience brings ourselves to this industry. And so that's one aspect of what Skylight Health does, is effectively delivering healthcare services through brick-and-mortar clinics, through telemedicine, through technology to millions of Americans across the U.S. today. The second aspect of our business, and this is a really exciting sort of branch off of the, let's call it, billion-dollar target that we have already in insurable services, is this chance to almost duplicate that exact same revenue within a smaller but rather untapped market potential. And we're talking here, Jack, about the uninsured patient community. We're talking about over 40 million Americans today who can't access adequate healthcare in the U.S. because of the high cost associated with health insurance plans. The average American who has to spend $6,000 to $15,000 a year on health insurance, and that doesn't even include their deductibles and their co-pays. I mean, for most people, this can be unaffordable. And so this is exactly where we find ourselves today. So what we've built here is we've built a platform that's a subscription model. It's a $200 a year program. And it's built off of the infrastructure on our insurable services side. So remember, we still have clinics, we're still delivering care, we have doctors, but these doctors can now spend time on these patients who don't have the ability to come visit us in our clinics or any clinics because they just don't have access to the insurance plans that helps them cover the cost of that delivery. So what do? They go to Google, maybe they self-diagnose, or they wait until it gets really bad, And then they end up with some serious issues that could get hospitalized. And so this $200 a year program, now think about this. If you're an uninsured patient, you can call Skylight, you can go online, you can subscribe to this program. Okay, it's $200 a year flat.
$199, right?
Sorry?
$199,
yeah, so it's $199 a year. $199 a year. And in fact, you can even do it monthly, or it's $24.99 per month, right? And you can subscribe. And let's say you're not feeling well one day. Well, now you can call Skylight or go online and book an appointment same or next day. And as long as we're in the state that you're in, you can consult with any one of our healthcare providers. This is an urgent care subscription program for the uninsured market, right? Now, anytime you go to a doctor, there's always copays, there's always deductibles, nothing here. You have your virtual visit, you see the doctor, maybe you get a diagnosis, maybe you get a prescription, but that's it. There's no additional costs. You can do it one time a year, you can do it 10 times a year. And so the idea behind this is that we are going to bring a product to this market that has been so vastly underserved with a program that's not requiring any kind of socialist behavior. This is a company that is funding this model. But because we are using our existing infrastructure, we're profitable here. So think about this. 40 million Americans, $200 a year. That's an $8 billion addressable market for us. And with nobody else playing in this space, this is, again, one of those unique moments where you can do well by doing good. And so we intend to take a large market share out of this population and be able to go in and provide real care to patients and in reality see a tremendous opportunity, $1 billion revenue opportunity just through this one platform alone, as it works alongside our other revenue streams, which in effect can be equivalent or more by themselves. And so this is why we're so excited about this recent release, because it's shining light on this huge need in a market that no one is really tackling today.
So, you know, so it's very interesting because, you know, the market, you know, a lot, you know, the market, the stock market, especially for in the micro cap, small cap space, it's a little bit, it's sort of like investors are distracted. It's sort of like a cat. They're distracted by, you know, shining objects like a little foil or something. But when it's something substantial, so they move very quickly for that little shiny, that string is shiny. But when it's something substantial, they're a little bit slower. They have to analyze it. It takes them so they're slower to react. So like this is a substantial piece of news, a substantial development, and so the investors haven't quite understood. But so let's kind of explain this. So this is on top of your existing model. This is, so it's an addition to what you're doing now. And again, we have a previous video people can watch where you really explain the details of the whole program and the massive opportunity and the traction, everything else. But you just for anybody that's new, just what your run rate right now, the traction that you have, so people know that, you know, this is, you guys have a real business here.
Yeah. So let's talk about what we have, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, right now we're sitting on about a $26 million run rate for 2021. And that's up 80% in the last few months, just purely based on the aggressive growth we've had in the consolidation space. The beauty of this is just scratching the surface. We still have over $75 million of deals in the pipeline, and that's growing month on month. And now we have significant cash to execute against it. We already had $10 million of cash on hand. This bought deal will bring in an additional $12 million of cash. And so now with over $20 million in cash, no debt, we're not burning any money. We're actually positive operating cash flow. We have all the capital to deploy towards recognizing the value we can gain in this $75 million plus pipeline opportunity. And we're very confident that the US market is going to continue to keep driving these kind of high acquisition opportunities our way as we continue to accelerate this growth. You know, we talk about, you know, a $2 stock, a $5 stock, a $10 stock. I mean, our goal is a $10 stock to a 20, to a 30, to a 40. How do you get that growth? You get that growth by constantly driving new innovation. That's not just about running five or six different businesses, but that's about running your one business, but has a chance to create revenue four, five, six different ways using the exact same infrastructure. And that's our thesis. That's exactly how our model works. You have a primary care model, but that's
the leverage. The leverage is the key.
Exactly.
I think you should also mention it's not purely an acquisition model. It's essentially the key to your model is the acquisition and then creating the organic growth, which 10x is. I don't want to put words in your mouth.
No, it's you take a patient, you take a revenue of $200 a year per patient in these clinics we acquire, and you take that to 1,000, to 2,000, to 5,000, to 10,000, just by layering on services. And that's the core business model. That's how you get, if you did nothing else but just go from 200 to 1,000, that's a 10x revenue on our existing patient base today. Forget anything we acquire. Then you layer on that $75 pipeline time and time again, and you can see how this grows. Then you take that 1,000 and turn to 10,000 by adding more services. Again, the growth is robust and endless. The beauty of this platform is it doesn't have to just be that one model. It can be this uninsured model. It could be other platforms that leverage the same infrastructure. So you're not just creating a dollar a specific way. We're mitigating the risk. We have revenue created in 2, 3, 4 different channels, and they're all focused on one market, one sector. We're hyper-focused. We don't change our perspective, but we find ways to create new alternative value for the company. And that is how we are confident we're going to drive this growth tremendously greater than where we are today. This is just the starting point, Jack, just the starting point.
Okay, so it's interesting. So you built, you have an infrastructure right now, but and you keep expanding the infrastructure, and you're layering on top of the infrastructure with you know these opportunities to leverage. Now, I just want to kind of jump back to this before we get into the discount, because this is the main thing I want to talk about. But you mentioned you have a pipeline of $75 million in potential acquisitions. That's the revenues that they have.
Revenue, correct. USD, yes.
USD, yeah, not Canadian, real money, right? So $75 million US dollars in revenue. That's in the pipeline that you have. So it doesn't mean that you're going to close all of it. You might close half. You might close double. It doesn't, you know, that's sort of like in the pipeline, basically.
It right? also doesn't mean that it's stagnant. 2 months ago, right. It was $10 million.
Right.
Today it's 75. I guarantee you, by the time we enter the new year, that's over $100 million. So whether or not we say no to one or two deals, the frequency at which these deal flows keep coming to us, there's going to be no shortage. It just comes down to how fast do we want to ingest them and how quickly do we want to layer on that type of growth. And like I said, we keep acquiring strong management with every acquisition, which just makes it faster and more and easier for us to increase the frequency and scale upon which we're going to layer on fundamental revenue. And remember, they're all profitable. So this is all going to mean immediate growth on the profitability margin, which means more cash on hand from operations, allowing more cash for acquisitions, and this cycle will just continue to repeat itself.
Okay. And okay, so the $75 million that's in the pipeline, right? That's mm-hmm. that's what they're doing now. So what happens is, in theory, right? Let's say you acquire those companies.
Yes.
You put your program to work, which drives the organic growth, and that $75 million is now $750 million.
Yeah, or more. That the ability for us to increase revenues by 5 or 10x with an existing facility. That's just, you know, that's exactly the model. And so you're getting that incremental 10x growth on a location without necessarily having to pay for it. You're paying at the one-time rate. You're getting the 10x value. And along the way, you're generating cash that allows us to go and acquire more one-time clinics to turn into 10x returns. And so this is the recipe that works. And this is the recipe that we've put for the last 4 months. It's worked so far, and we're just going to keep rolling it out.
Okay. No, here's what I like about this model is, in terms of from the market perspective, I'm just speaking strictly from, you know, the stock market perspective, you know, not as an industry expert in healthcare, but, you know, in terms of the model, this is kind of like that super stock model. This is where you have like a big market. It's fast moving. So it's sort of like it's not just a fast train, but it's a fast car on top of that fast train. And they're all going to, and it's just like that flywheel. It's like a fly, you know, the flywheel. This is like the Amazon. That's the new thing that everybody in consulting is saying, the flywheel. That's the magic thing now.
Look, it's a snowball effect. It's just
snowball.
So it's a snowball effect. It just continues to just keep building momentum. As it gets bigger, it gets more and more powerful, and we can ingest more and more. And it's just, like I said, this is an engine that feeds itself, and it's just going to keep getting bigger.
So the market, I think what the market is going to need, though, is if you have this pipeline of acquisitions. Okay, so now, Pratt, here's the problem, right? You have this big story. You laid out the story. Now, you know, the investors are going to say, okay, we got to see the how fast, you know, they want to see that velocity of deals. Now they're going to pay attention to when you're going to start closing these deals, because now that this is part of the story, is because that's going to, you know, that's going to drive the essentially the appreciation of the stock. So the velocity, the closing rate, and the scale. So velocity and scale, those are going to be the two things to watch in January. So you better deliver.
We will deliver. Don't you worry.
Okay. So let's jump into this, the discount drug, because this is the thing, again, the market hasn't understood it, and it's a key thing. So this, explain how, because it's $199, somebody pay, it's a subscription model, right? Which is great, yep, because the market loves subscription recurring revenue.
Correct.
Now, here's the question. How do you make money with this? How do you turn a profit with this at $199?
So we're profitable from day one. Two reasons. One, we already have critical mass. We've got over 130,000 patients already registered with us today.
Okay.
The platform of the $200 a year works with our existing physicians and staff. So we're not building a new business or hiring new people or having to build this whole infrastructure out. It's already working off of what we already have today. All we're doing is we're saying, here's a market today that would have otherwise never have been your customer because they can't afford the services you deliver because it's insurable.
Okay.
And we're saying they also don't have any other solution. Where do they go? And whether Bidencare 2.0 ever gets the traction it needs to, I mean, we know Obamacare didn't get the traction it needed to. This is the solution. This is what you do to create affordable access. And when you create affordable access in a market that is looking for solutions that are low cost, that is going to, I think, be the perfect storm for building that $1 billion revenue opportunity. And when you're profitable, you're signing up patients every month, each patient adds direct contribution, you're going to create more value for these patients, like this discount card program. And that's just going to create more for a reason to want to participate in a program like this. I mean, when you look at our battle cards against other competitors in the market today, whether it's a Teladoc or an MD Live, the number one feature in this product is the price. And the price just cannot be beat. And we're going to continue to keep driving this message forward. And as we continue to add more services, the value cannot be beat. And that is how we create a robust competitive plan around what it is we're doing. And that's why we're so confident. And I know it's sometimes people don't see it, but I say it again, over 40 million people today at $200 a year, that's $8 billion in a total addressable market. And I'm not even talking about the trillion-dollar healthcare industry.
And do you have a partner? You have a partner in this that's big. I mean, this is like a model. This is not like something that you guys just invented yesterday and said, hey, let's. I mean, there's a model. This has been modeled out, like how you make money with this. What percentage of people will use it? This is like a it's sort of like the tape. You have like a whole spreadsheet of, So who's a partner in this deal with you?
You know, there's experience behind this, Jack. We've been running this type of $200 a year capitation model here in Canada for over 10 years. We know this model really well. It's existed here for a very long time. The fact that it's new to the US market is only that it's disruptive, but it's not new to us. And how to utilize this program to get the most out of the program for the patient and the company, that's a recipe that we have. And that's what we're deploying down into the US market. And we'll partner with people like United Networks of America, who do the discount drug cards. Certainly not exclusive to any one partner, and we don't want to be. We want to create as much value for the patient as possible, because at the end of the day, you want to reach millions and millions of patients. And while this is built for the 40 million Americans, there's no reason why the other 260 million can't benefit from a program like this either. And that's the virtue of growth in a platform like this, is as you add more, you start to get accretive value for new people to join. And as new people join, the word spreads. And again, we've run this business platform before. This is not new to us.
Okay, let's jump into some audience questions. So, sure. Great question here. How do you plan on marketing this?
So, good question. So, there's a few different pilots that we ran in the last couple of months that have shown some success. We've gone the traditional social media advertising, digital advertising, boots on the ground, kind of community-based advertising, and that's more in a B2C based mindset. We are starting to expand on B2B opportunities. And so if you think about the number of people that can benefit from this, one of the greatest pools of employment groups that can benefit are the small to medium sized companies. And I know this speaking as one in the US, where you've got a number of employees, you offer a health plan, but they can't afford the copay. And how do you retain these employees that tomorrow could just go to McDonald's and work for the same rate potentially and get health insurance? And so this is a product by which companies are able to offer as a value add. It's not expensive, and it probably contains their premiums. So part of our advertising and marketing model on this is to go directly to the small to medium size industry, where you're able to have bulk enrollment instead of individual enrollment. And so that is part of the strategy for 2021.
Okay. So that's going to be where you get that kind of leverage and growth is, you know, you have marketing to, you know, small, medium businesses where they have, you know, I don't know, a dozen employees, whatever it is. So this is, exactly. And you can have signups. Okay. Let's see, we got, let's go to the question. Good question here. Shafin is asking, who's your biggest competitor in the marketplace right now? I guess it's open-ended. It means like you're in a few areas, right? So who's your biggest competitors?
Let's talk about the discount car program for a second. Yep. So in the uninsured market, we're not playing with anybody at this price point. We've looked, and when we brought this product to market, we did our homework to see, and maybe there's others that'll come up and others that will start to lower some of their pricing. But at the price points we offer, at the value we offer, we play within a very niche space right now. In terms of insurable services, yeah, we compete with other clinics and doctors and hospital networks, but there's a reason we're doing what we're doing in the consolidation space. We're buying existing practices with existing patients. I don't have to build a clinic and wait 2 years and hope I can get 10,000 patients. We get that from day one. Our magic is not getting the 10,000 patients. Our magic is taking that revenue from 1x to 10x on those 10,000 patients. And that's the secret sauce here. So I shouldn't say that, I guess, but that's what we do.
Okay. So I get, is he asking, like, do you compete with like the, what is it? The 1MD or the, what is it? The Oak Street. Is that competition for you or no?
No, not really. I mean, Oak Street focuses purely on senior care continuum. We focus on patients across the entire spectrum of care. You know, there's corporate healthcare systems. We're the anti-corporate healthcare system. You know, we're the system the way that healthcare should have been to begin with, where you walk in, you know your staff, you know your doctors, you've got that one-on-one relationship with your physician and their team. And it's a team-based approach. We bring that care team to the patient.
Derek is asking about the, what's your target number of subscriptions with this program? Great question. In the first year, what's your target number?
Well, we have internal targets that, you know, relatively conservative in terms of how much we want to approach. But I'll say the same thing. I mean, whether it's the first 6 months or the first 3 months or the first 12 months, what we're determining right now is what is that recipe of marketing success on that per customer acquisition cost that everybody likes to see on the metrics, so you can understand what the return on each patient contribution is going to be, so that I can apply that same formula to millions. I don't want to go after just 100 at a time or 1,000 at a time. I want to make sure that the target stays on a sizable percentage of that 40 million market share.
Bob is asking an interesting question. So after the subscription, the $199, you call in for the virtual. Are there any fees afterwards?
No, that's it, Bob. That's it. That's what it is. There's no hidden gimmicks. There's no back-end fees. That's it. One time payment, all year round access. That's okay. The beauty of this capitation model. And like I said,
you've done it before.
People don't believe it. We've done this before. Yeah. There's a recipe to this.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Okay. DK, will we see another acquisition the next 12 days?
I think we've been pretty aggressive in terms of putting out, I mean, it's 5 announced to date so far. I mean, we've already closed on 2 and the other 3 will close sometime between now and the end of January. So we're going to focus on making sure that those ones get closed. To your point, Jack, that's critical. 2 out of the 5 and soon enough, 5 out of the 5. But before we close all 5, don't worry. I think we'll have some news flow that's going to excite our shareholders.
Okay. So let's just maybe revisit this. So I guess one part of the kind of the whole story here is, you know, how you get that 10x organic once you buy, you know, once you make an acquisition, how do you get that 10x? So that's what Jeremy is asking. Can you elaborate how you will get 10 times more money from each patient? You mentioned it like multiple, but let's just address it.
I mean, think about each service you receive. So you go in to see your family doctor, right? That's 1. Your family doctor refers you out to a specialist. That's 2. Your specialist might offer you a couple of products or services to support your needs. That's 3. So think of the amount of frequency of times this happens with different specialists, different referrals, and then sometimes even more increased frequency with your own family doctor. That's how you layer on the 10x revenue. Because in a fee-for-service model, the more interactions you have with a patient, the more opportunities you have to bill for those interactions. And so we take these clinics from seeing their patients once or twice a year to at least 3 to 5 times a year, just that family doctor alone, to then increasing that frequency with more specialists, more services offered in clinic to that patient. And that's how you drive that growth.
Okay. And I think you might want to also add, you've done this, I mean, this model, you've had this model working, right? This is a proven model you have.
Exactly. I mean, we've started practices where we began with 3 family doctors, gotten up to 8,000 patients. And over the course of the next 2 years, we have 26 services offered in that one clinic to those 8,000 patients. You don't even have to get 8,001. 8,000 is enough. And then you can build on that one 8,001, one 9,000, one 10,000. But the multidisciplinary model, the layering on of services, this is something that is happening. And it's not new to us. It's not new to the industry. But it is something that offers a disruptive platform in what we offer.
Okay, so I've actually used the wrong word. I said it's a proven model, but really it's a system. So you really have a proven system that worked, and now you're just gonna scale it up. So that essentially that's the key part of the investment story is like, okay, you have a proven system that essentially 10x's these acquired clinics, and you're just gonna add more. So just that there's your thing. Okay, so now we have did we even talk about this? So you're gonna uplist on the TSXV, right? The venture.
Yeah. So we received conditional approval last week, which will basically mean we'll delist off the CSE and then uplist onto the Toronto Stock Exchange Venture. We expect to do that in January. So if all goes well, we'll expect to be on there in January.
Okay. So that's good. It's good progress. Okay.
It's gonna be great. It's gonna open up some significant liquidity and access for new money and institutional capital. And of course, it's a much more US friendly exchange as well. So we expect to see that drive overall improved liquidity for the company.
Okay. And also, I guess probably the follow up question is people are going to ask me, when are you going on NASDAQ? I mean, assuming the price is there, what you have any plans for 21?
Yeah, look, it's in the cards. We want uplist. We want to be on a bigger exchange. We want access to more liquidity. We want access to bigger institutional capital. And we're working on it. Look, last 3 months, we've gone from zero coverage to now 3 analysts in Canada covering our story. And, that's on the back of, let's call it almost over 1,000% growth in the stock price since the COVID days. And so we're going to continue this execution. Look, if anything, Jack, we deliver. We say what we're going to do, we go do it. And, sometimes we may not put all the targets out, but we like to over deliver in most cases. So our goal is going to be the same. We're going to keep rinse and repeating. We're going to get these revenues aggressively growing, profitability aggressively growing, and we're going to use that as a chance to continue to get more exposure. And we're going to institutionalize that capital base in the US as well. It's going to happen. It's just a question of continued execution.
No, this is the type of story that would do very well in the US. Like once you have a NASDAQ listing, this is something that, you have massive base of investors who love, healthcare deals.
Yeah, look, we've already been around numerous banks so far this year and met with a number of different analysts at the banks and bankers and told the story. And the reception has been nothing but positive. And in the past, there's been this failed attempt at primary care consolidation by public or private equity groups. But the way we're approaching the market and the way that we're approaching our store, our system is far more credible and based on experience. And we're getting that kind of support from the exposure we're getting with these meetings. And so that's where I see further validation and continued belief in the business model.
Oh, so you're already like speaking with US investors, US institutions, like kind of laying the ground.
I mean, look, we're getting exposure. I mean, having an opportunity to create an increased shareholder value, increased liquidity and exposure in the US market with our business is drawing attention. And we're certainly taking on more inbound requests at the moment.
Yeah, I think, as the stock kind of like, goes up that ladder, like, let's say $2, then it becomes more like, attractive for institutions. Because, when it's at a dollar range, they kind of feel, they they might be embarrassed to have that on their portfolio, because it's just psychological. But if it's $2, all of a sudden, then it's like, and then $3, $5, once you pass $5, then it becomes like, okay, hey, we got to get in. So a question from Shafin is asking, what do you think the challenges you are going to face to achieve your goals, which is, I guess, the, this organic 10X model, and how are you going to tackle those? And maybe he's also asking about the acquisitions. Open-ended.
Sure. Look, we'd love to acquire as many companies as we see in front of us, and we're going to get as good as we can at consolidating as many of these as possible. Look, the challenges we will face will be anything that's operational in nature. You have capacity, you have people, you have infrastructure. But like I said, we're buying these same infrastructures with each acquisition we do. And so we're getting stronger as we're getting bigger. And those two go hand in hand together, allowing us to execute what we need to execute. But this is not a business model that's new to us. And we recognize that there are risks and we know the challenges and we've foreseen most of them because we know they're coming. And so it's about how you plan for them. It's about how you recognize that building a business requires a strong foundation and it comes down to your people at the end of the day. And I'm proud to say we have a very strong team and that team is only getting stronger acquisition by acquisition.
Okay. Let's kind of, I guess, wrap up with the financing. So we talked about TSX. We got the subscription side here, which is impressive. So you're raising how much? $12 million?
$12 million. Yeah.
Okay, and it's a bought deal, so it's a done deal basically at this point.
Yeah, it closes end of the month. So
okay. Officially. Okay, so you get the money. I don't know. January comes in the bank account basically.
Hopefully a little bit sooner. We're all trying to work before the holidays kick in, so we'll see how far we get.
Okay, and the next question is, okay, how are you going to deploy this growth capital? And how much are you going to have after the $12 million? How much are you going to have in the bank, roughly?
Oh, about $22 million.
$22 million. Okay, so that's a good position.
Yeah, it's a great position to be in, especially when you're not burning any money. So it's all going to growth. And let's look at the last 3 months. So we raised about $10 million to date. And through the five announcements that we've made so far, that $10 million has driven in about $13 million in revenue and about $2 to $3 million in profit, but has only taken up about 50% of that $10 million. So I basically spent $5 million and acquired $13 million with about $2 to $3 million in positive EBITDA. And so it's almost at the point where for every $1 million we spend, we're basically buying or getting in return $2 to $3 million back in return. And so when we look at our deal pipeline and we look at the number of deals we have in front of us, we're certainly intelligent on how we want to structure these deals to conserve cash and take it as far as possible. But we're also talking about a disciplined acquisition model that's not paying 3-4 times revenue for each of these deals. These are structured deals at 3 to 7 times EBITDA. They're immediately profitable and revenue generating. And, you know, I've said it before, I'll say it again into a sneak peek. Yes, we're working on a couple of 8-figure transactions and these are going to be transformative for us as a business, but also transformative for us as a team, because it's just going to help us further accelerate our management capabilities to be able to continue to build on this type of robust acquisition model. So that, you know, use of proceeds has a direct line of sight right now in terms of acquisition targets that we intend to move into in 2021. And I'm pretty excited for what that's going to mean in terms of fundamental growth, transformative growth from what people are expecting us to actually do next year.
Okay. All right, Pratt, let's wrap up. Last question. Do we have any, see if we have any audience questions? And then I'm going to ask you, you know, our favorite, which you've answered multiple times. I mean, you've actually answered the question, but I'm going to ask you just to repeat just because that's, yeah, you know, we have a system. You have a system. We have a system.
Yeah. Love your system.
So this is it. So Pratt, the favorite question we have at Wall Street Reporter, you know, in your opinion, again, top three reasons why investors should, you know, consider Skylight Health stock today.
Because I truly, truly believe we're about to take off and we are just getting started. I mean, you know, 80% growth in run rate revenue already over the last 3 months. I significantly expect to blow that out of the water next year. We are profitable. We are cash flow positive. We have no debt. We have now further strengthened our balance sheet with an additional financing. And we have a direct line of target into acquisitions that are just continuing to build month on month. Secondly, we're a management team that knows what we're doing. We've done this before, not once, but many times over. But now we have access to a much larger market. We have strong investment support, and we have access to capital to deploy a strategy that can take us into really a multi-billion dollar revenue business. And then lastly, we're building more exposure. Like I said, in Canada, we've significantly institutionalized our capital base, gotten more research coverage, improved liquidity, share prices gone significantly better since the start of this pandemic. And We're just starting to scratch the surface in the U.S. market, and we all know the depth of the U.S. market and the liquidity and the growth that this market can bring us. And so I'm just more so confident and excited that delivering on something we know in a market we just have so much potential in, with people who are listening and like the model, we're just going to see this thing. It's a perfect storm, Jack. It's a perfect storm.
Okay, excellent. Prad, on that note, I want to thank you. I don't know if we're going to have you on before the end of the year, but if you know, we might, right? If you have any some news. But until then, Prad, thank you again for joining us. Thank you, everybody, for joining our live stream today. And we'll see you on the next one.
Thanks, Jack.